About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.
Welcome to the Berks County Kennel Club's program, All About Dogs. Hi, I'm Pat Mock, your host. And this evening, we've got some big dogs for you. Actually, these are the giants of the dog world. The Irish setter, the gray one who has his head right here, I think has the title as the tallest dog, a dog breed, actually. And the Great Dane on the other side, the brown ones, this is actually the state dog of Pennsylvania. Now, for those of you who don't know about all states have a breed of dog. They have a bird. Ours happens to be the ruffed grouse. They have a flower. Ours is a mountain laurel. A little bit of history there. So anyway, this is the state dog of Pennsylvania. So we're going to be talking first of all to the Irish Wolfhounds and find out just a little bit about them. Obviously, they're from Ireland. This is Prince Valiant's dog, right? The one that Maeve has?
No, I'm not sure.
Really? No. In the cartoon? Isn't it? You don't know either? Well, you have a Great Dane. What would you know? I'm pretty sure these are the hounds that Maeve has in the Prince Valiant comic strips.
Okay.
Yeah, because they're always out hunting something or other. The stag hounds and whatever, you know, the deer hounds. But they're Scottish, and you know, we know Prince Valiant is English, so. But anyhow, I think that's what you guys are, right? Now, they're called wolfhounds. Were they used to hunt wolves?
Well, yeah. Years ago, way back when, the Irish people used them. They're a coursing hound.
Okay.
And they were used to kill wolves. They were used to kill Irish elk. And they were also used, actually, to take horseback riders down in battle.
Really?
Yep.
Well, they definitely have the size, and, you know, a dog flying up out of nowhere certainly would, you know, knock you off the horse. Wow, I didn't know they were used as war dogs.
Yeah.
Jeez. So, was this, like, in the outer country, or did they have these guys, like, living in the cities as well? Or, you know, like, were they, like, a game hunter's
dog?
Yeah,
they were. There was a big, coursing in Ireland was a big sport for the people, and it was popular in Ireland, England, and I mean, these dogs go back to actually the Roman times, when the Romans invaded Ireland, they actually took the dogs back to Rome with them.
Oh,
so they were they were a noble dog for nobility.
Uh-huh.
And but what really happened to the breed was they actually killed all the elk and the wolves in Ireland, and then the people really stopped breeding them because the sport was gone. So they actually, the breed almost went into extinction.
How about that? Now, what was that, like in the 17th, 16th?
It would be in the 1800s.
Okay, the 1800s,
yeah.
Okay, that late.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, wow, how about that? So then they were used actually as a sport dog as well as a dog that got food for the people.
Yeah.
Right,
yeah.
Okay. Now, when you said coursing, we don't know what coursing is. So
well,
you explain just a little bit about what coursing is.
A sight hound actually sees its game, runs it down, and kills it.
Okay.
And so the Irish would take him out. They let him go for deer or elk or wolves.
So then would they gang up on the animal, or
they
would they just hold it? And
oh, they kill the animal.
Oh, they kill it.
They'll run it down and snap the neck of the animal.
Oh, okay.
They're doing some coursing in the United States with jackrabbits, coyote, but that's mostly out west, not in our areas.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I know they have coursing, lure coursing, but, you know, that's here. I know that's here, I guess, in New Jersey, they do a lot of that.
A lot of wolfhound owners love the lure coursing, and it's very popular, and they also do what they call straight track racing, which is just like, some people call it doggy drag racing.
Okay.
You know, it's like a 400-yard, 500-yard course.
Well, I think they used to do that with the Whippets.
Mm-hmm.
That was one of the things that the Whippets did was straight coursing rather than after something. Sure they probably did after something as well, but... Geez, that's really interesting. Now, you would think, when people think sight hounds, they think whippets and, you know, greyhounds, not big mooses like these. You know, what else? I mean, that's a big dog.
Well, yeah, and when you look at an Irish Wolfhound, you should be seeing a greyhound shape in the dog.
Okay.
Just a rough-coated, what a lot of people would call a rough-coated greyhound.
Okay. You know,
much larger in size, much heavier in bone.
Yeah.
But don't be fooled, because these dogs can really, they can run fast.
Yeah. Now, do they need a lot of exercise?
They do. If
Hey, Guy, you want to turn around
here? Where are you going?
And so we can see your head. I really don't care. We know you have a tail.
Yeah. He says,
there you go. That's much better.
They do need a lot. They do need a lot of exercise. I think they really get a lot of exercise from walking.
Oh, okay.
You know?
Okay. So they don't need to get out there and run.
Well, like these two, these are very young wolfhounds. These are only 16 months old.
So, okay.
I mean, they really exercise hard with each other.
Okay.
But as they get older, we get what we call couch potatoes.
Oh, okay.
So then you better put them on a leash and take them for a 5-mile walk, because they're going to need it. So.
Now, they're both the same age?
It's a brother and sister.
Okay, so he's that much, I mean, he sort of like dwarfs her.
Yes, and she's actually a nice-sized female.
Really? But the males are that much bigger?
He's a big wolfhound.
Wow. Yeah. How tall is he?
I'm a measure now.
He's about 30, 32 at least.
Oh, no, he's probably 30.
How tall is he?
He's
probably
37.
Yeah, 37? I would think he's 30,
oh, my God.
36 or 37. They're
well, if he's 37, then he's probably a little bit bigger.
Yeah, he's tall.
Yeah, he is. He's not going to get any bigger.
Well, wolfhounds were striving to have males at 33 inches at the shoulder,
okay,
as a minimum.
Okay.
And 31 for females. But it's not a measurable breed.
Okay.
So if you're judging wolfhounds, You could never bring a wicket in and say I don't think the dog's too small.
Okay.
You know, so you can't. It's not a measurable breed. The judge has to, in his own mind, decide if that dog's big enough to actually do what he was bred to do.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. When he's talking about a wicket, they actually bring in a U-shaped piece of metal, and they stand the dog on a wooden platform, and they put this over the dog's shoulder. So if the maximum height of the dog is only supposed to be, say, 26 inches, they'll screw the feet down to 26 inches, lay it over the dog's shoulders. If it touches the board, then the dog is in size. If it doesn't touch the board, the dog is disqualified. And, is measured, they call it measured out. So then the dog is disqualified from the ring. You can't show the dog until he comes, if he does come back into size. Most people, once the dogs are disqualified, don't bother to show them any longer. But anyhow, so how popular is this breed? You never see this breed walking down the street.
No, I don't think it's a popular breed. They're a hard luck breed. They have a lot of health issues. So
oh, really?
People that get involved with wolfhounds seem to stick with them.
Uh-huh.
But it's not the kind of, they're an expensive breed to raise. It's not the kind of breed that a lot of people are going to, go to and you need property.
Right.
So
yes,
you need
yes
a deep,
you do. You know, I mean, just even just with one, you need a fair amount of room.
Yeah, I mean, this isn't a dog you're going to raise in the city.
Right. That's exactly right. That's exactly right. What health problems do they have? What are they prone to? They don't live very long.
No,
right?
The three big things in wolfhounds for mortality are a heart disease, cancer, and bloat.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, those are three biggies. Are three biggies. It's not a little piddly disease that you're talking about. Wow. But I think cancer, I think in a lot of breeds, is getting more and more prevalent, unfortunately.
We're seeing more cancer in our breed now, I think, than we've ever had.
Wow.
You know.
It's just so unfortunate. It's just, what do you do? You know, there's...
Well, we're doing a lot of, the Irish Wolfhound Club of America is doing a lot of research.
Uh-huh, uh-huh.
And the Broad Institute up in Harvard is actually running a cancer study right now.
Okay, okay.
So
what kind of cancer are they prone to? All of them, or is it mostly bone?
It's mostly bone cancer,
bone
yeah.
Cancer,
but
yeah.
They're we've had lymphosarcoma and other things too,
Wow. So let's get on to happy subjects.
Yeah.
They come in other colors.
They do.
Okay. What other colors do they come in? What color is that?
Well, I would call this dog a gray brindle.
Okay.
And she, I don't know what she is. She has some red in her, but the acceptable colors, and the standard says that anything in a Scottish deerhound coat is acceptable in an Irish wolfhound.
Okay.
But what we're looking at is reds, blacks, grays, fawns, like the Dane and Wheaton's.
Wow.
And then what they would call brindle, which would be like a mixture of those colors.
Yes, yes. You know, it's just that I'm so used to seeing this color, you know, the brindles. I don't think I've ever seen a black.
Yeah, the blacks are, it's hard to get a pure black yeah. Irish Wolfhound. Mm-hmm. You'll get them, then they'll gray out a lot.
Mm-hmm. Now, they have funny ears.
Mm-hmm.
They're called what? Rose ears.
Rose ears, yep.
Why does it help with the speed?
Well,
the Greyhound, too, has that kind of ear, right?
It does. I mean, they got the whole streamline effect, but the one thing you don't want on a wolfhound that's trying to kill a wolf is a ear that's flapping where the wolf could actually get a hold of that ear.
That's true.
So you want to keep, they actually should have those ears back. That's a fault in the breed,
right.
A flat-hanging ear.
Yeah, okay. I thought it was just for the speed.
It's not something that you would dismiss the dog when judging in it, but you would have to judge that as
a fault.
As a fault,
sure,
yes.
Sure. Now, they have a very rough coat. They're not soft and smooth and silky. You know, you look at this coat and you say, oh, it looks so nice and silky, but it's not.
No, and actually, I washed these two dogs today, and they're actually very harsh yet, even from washing them.
Yeah.
They're supposed to have a very harsh coat. If you really see a good wolfhound coat and you try to wash them, they really don't get wet.
Uh-huh.
You know, the water kind of just repels off of them.
Well, I would think, too, that they would need the harsh coat because of the stuff that they're running through, the brambles and sticks and that kind of, that it would just brush right off of them. Did they come at all from the Afghans? What do you think was involved in making a wolfhound? When you go back so many years, if they're a sighthound, did the sighthounds just happen in different areas?
Well, the modern day wolfhound is really not what you would read about in history in like in the 1400s and the 1500s.
Oh,
because like I said earlier, the breed almost went to extinction.
Yeah.
There was a Father Hogan and a Captain Graham who resurrected the breed, and they went around Ireland and England and tried to find dogs that they felt had wolfhound in, and they also used some Great Dane to bring the breed back. They've used some Mastiff, so this is what we're calling an Irish Wolfhound now.
Okay.
But it really isn't what
you would have had way back.
Read in history. The other thing is that it got so bad that there was deerhound litters, and if some of the puppies in the deerhound litter were of a heavier bone, they called them wolfhounds.
Really?
Yeah, and they put them aside, and that's how they also tried to bring the breed back.
Yeah. Well, I guess there's not that much difference between the deerhound and the wolfhound.
Well, I mean, if you
a narrower head.
Right, if you see a deerhound, it's just going to be slighter in bone.
Yeah, I mean, you know that it's a deerhound, but, it does look different than the wolfhound. When you said you groom these guys, how long does it take? Do they need to be brushed every day? Is it pretty wash and wear?
They're pretty wash and wear. They need to be tidy. When I show the dogs, I want the dogs to be tidy, clean. But they should be shown pretty much as in a natural coat.
Okay.
You know, we're not looking for like the poodle. You know, where you have this immaculate grooming. You know,
so grooming.
If you read the standard, it says it's a rough-coated breed, so you want coat on the dog.
Yeah, okay. Okay, we have to take a break, so stay tuned. We'll be right back.
You're watching All About Dogs on bctv.org. Be informed. Be involved. Be a member. For membership information, go to www.bctv.org/support/membership. For more information and other stories about animals and pets, go to www.bctv.org. County Kennel Club and by Burke's Dog Training Club. For more information on how you and your business can become program underwriters, go to www.bctv.org.
We were just talking during the break. This litter that he has, this brother and sister, they were born on Valentine's Day, and there were 14 puppies in the litter. Imagine feeding 14 of these guys. Jeez.
It was fun.
How many do you have?
What do we have now? Five. We only have five now.
Five, okay. Yeah. Well, that's more than I would want, but oh, well. Are they easy to train? they're or do not, they have their own agenda kind of thing?
They kind of do. They're not your big obedience dog.
Okay.
You know, but they want to please you.
Okay.
You
okay.
know, so they're, I mean, they're just docile dogs.
Yeah. And they seem very sweet.
They are.
They just seem very sweet.
I mean, this is what they excel at right here.
Oh, sleeping.
They love to lay around and they just want to be with people.
Well, that's great. That's very good. Very good. Okay. Let's go to the Great Danes. So, another big dog. These have a little more jowl than the other ones, so they are more. They have more of a tendency to
drool.
I was going to say drizzle, but
some drool more than others. There are some that they consider dry mouths. This guy is not really a big drooler.
Okay, well that's good.
I mean, he's
good
for the most part. Only when he drinks, and when he drinks, you better stand back.
Uh huh. Well, you don't have to wash the kitchen.
Yeah, you just tell everybody you have frosted windows.
Yes, yeah. Now, why was this dog bred? Where did it come from? It's a German dog, right?
Right. Okay. They're from Germany originally, okay. And they were bred to hunt wild boar in a pack and to guard estates.
Okay.
So they were a working dog, and they were used, they were to be fearful.
Mm-hmm. And, well, you see a dog like this coming up to you, and it's like, okay, whatever you want to do is all right with me, dog.
Yep. And like you said, with them, with the ears, that's the original reason why they cropped the Danes, because the wild boars would grab the ears.
Oh, okay.
So they cropped them to keep the ears on.
Uh-huh. Huh, how about that?
And then
they have such a strange ear. Was this just style that it got longer and longer?
It got longer and longer. People made it longer to make them look more aesthetic to the eye.
Uh-huh.
And they wanted that debonair look. His ears are actually, the puppies are longer than his.
Mm-hmm.
He's an import from Finland.
Okay. Now, did you get him as a puppy? Was
yes,
it, were
I
his
did.
Ears done here?
No,
or they
his
were done
ears
over
were
there?
Done here, and because he was older, they cropped them shorter because they were afraid they wouldn't stand.
Okay. Yeah, and if they don't stand, it's sort of like, you know.
Yeah,
right.
Yeah.
But they do show this breed with the flop ears.
Yes, they do.
The drop ear now is just as acceptable as the stand-up ear,
yes,
correct?
Yes, it is.
Very good.
It's all a preference. I personally like them cropped. I think they look more, they just look fancier.
Well, they look elegant.
Yeah.
You know, they look very elegant. They sort of look a little bit goofy, but maybe because we're so used to seeing the stand-up ears.
Unfortunately, because we've been cropping since the beginning when they were brought over in the late 1800s, we have not bred for proper ear set.
Mm-hmm.
So most of them over here, if you don't crop their ears, they get a real long, big hound ear.
Yes.
Whereas over in Europe, where they don't crop, they have a much smaller, nice, tight laying ear to the head.
Oh, okay. So then they actually—I guess it's like the Schnauzers. They're breeding for erect ears with the Schnauzers as well.
Right.
Yeah. So how popular is this breed?
Well,
I mean, in your house, it's very popular. What do you have? 10?
Actually, there's more Great Danes in this area of the country than any other area of the country, and that's basically because this is the state dog of Pennsylvania.
Okay. All right. Yeah, that's logical.
We get the biggest entries in the dog shows around here,
uh-huh.
And actually, a lot of times, the Great Dane is one of the largest entries.
Wow. Okay.
And
so
they come in 6 different colors.
Uh-huh.
That are acceptable. They come in a lot of colors, but there's 6 acceptable colors. This is considered a fawn with a black mask. They come in a brindle, which is a stripe.
Do
like
they
a
all
tiger.
Have the black masks?
No.
Oh,
just
okay.
The fawns and the brindles.
Okay.
And then there's a harlequin, which is white with black spots. And
okay,
they have
it looks
to
like
be,
a Dalmatian.
Right. They have to be evenly dispersed. And then there's a blue, which is like a steel blue color. And then there's the black, solid black.
Okay.
And now they have also accepted the mantle, which is the white with a black saddle. It almost reminds you of a Boston Terrier with the black saddle.
Oh, really? They're that light? Wow.
Well, no, they have white down the front, and then they have a black saddle.
Oh, the whole dog is black, but it has a thingy around
its
neck.
And they must have a white tip on their tail.
Oh, good grief. I shouldn't and laugh because my breed has to have a black tip on its tail. So
preferably
you know.
They have black on their, like, the majority of their head.
Okay.
So,
So it's pleasant. It's yes. pleasant to look at.
Yeah, it's a, right. it's a very it has to be very symmetrical to make it work.
Yes. Yes.
So
now, does this breed require a lot of exercise?
Not really.
Oh, okay.
They pretty well, by the time they hit age two, they become couch potatoes.
Wow.
They'll run, and they can run for a long distance, but then they will nap.
Okay.
And
so you think, you know, you're getting a giant dog, and it's going to require lots and lots of exercise, but it's obviously just the opposite. It's a giant breed, so it tires out faster
yes,
than
do.
Your medium-sized dog. So this dog would not be going like a lab.
No, absolutely not.
The lab
they don't have that type of, they're very, for the most part, low-key. We teach them right from the beginning that they can't jump, so they mm-hmm. won't, they're just going to stand to be petted.
They are leaners.
They are leaners. They do like to lean on you. They like to back up and sit on your lap. As he does, they like to lay on you.
Uh-huh.
They're very family oriented. They become a real big part of the family. Like, they want to do what you're doing. They want to be with you all the time.
Okay. So then you don't have aggression in this breed?
Well, when they first came to the United States,
well, they were
yes.
guard dogs, yeah.
Yes, you know, but we have, for the most part, bred it out.
Okay.
And, I mean, I myself would not breed to a male if I didn't like the disposition.
Okay.
Because I do feel that they belong in family homes, and I wouldn't want to put them in a home with children mm-hmm. if I couldn't trust what they were going to be.
Plus the size of the dog, if you have aggression in either one of these breeds, I mean, you can do real harm with
Absolutely.
A dog that size.
Absolutely.
I mean, even just them plowing into you because they haven't had training, which I assume you also recommend.
Yes.
Obedience training very early on.
Whenever they leave my house, I recommend that they crate train because they're no different than a chihuahua, except a chihuahua may nibble on the chair and they will eat the chair.
Yes.
So
their tails are also dangerous weapons, right?
Right. Their tails can, now his isn't excessively long. Some of them are a little longer and mm-hmm. they do become weapons.
Yes.
Some of them are real tail waggers. I have one right now that I'm taking care of. She actually, when she wags her tail, her whole body wags, she hits herself in the face.
Oh my
word. I never
word.
Saw anything like it, but I'm just waiting for it to hit the wrong thing and
oh
split.
Oh my word.
But yeah, they can. Their tails can be dangerous and, you know, it's just a lot of it's training.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Like we pretty much don't let them get away with a whole lot of stuff and,
well,
I recommend that they crate train them, and
yeah.
I also recommend that they do at least a simple obedience.
Yeah,
because nothing's more beautiful than walking a Great Dane down the sidewalk, and it's walking next to you with its ears up, and it looks debonair.
Right, right.
It's not attractive to watch somebody belly crawl.
And that's what I was going to say. You know, a small lady, it's like, wow.
And,
you know, the dog would just take them.
And I'm sure same way with the Irish Wolfhounds. When you're at a show, everybody thinks they're so wonderful because they're you know, they
mm-hmm.
see. But I explained to them that takes a lot of work for it to be what it is today.
Yes, that's exactly right. So now, what health problems do they have?
Pretty much the same as your Irish Wolfhounds.
Really?
They bloat. There are some hereditary heart problems that you have to be, you know, careful about, and they get bone cancer as well.
Wow.
And they don't live real long, so you know I always, you know, if you're going to take on a Great Dane, you have to be willing to accept that it won't be with you forever.
Yeah. What is the lifespan about? 10?
It varies by color.
Okay.
Most of ours are anywhere from 8 to 10.
Okay. And that's about how long your guys go too, right? 8 to 10?
Well, no, we're actually saying 6 to 7.
Oh my word.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
That would kill me. That would kill me. Yes.
Well, the oldest wolfhound I've had was 10. I've had a couple at 10 years old.
Wow.
And I know I saw a wolfhound at 14 years old years ago. That's the oldest dog I ever saw.
Jeez. Yeah. That's. Now these are not the same age, right?
No, he's 2,
okay.
And this one is 6 months old.
Because he sort of obliterates you and, you know, the little one over there.
This
now, that's a boy, too, right?
Yes.
They're both boys.
He's
okay.
6 months old.
Okay. So this is what you got at 6 months old, people. So, you know, if you're interested in a Great Dane, they don't stay puppy very long. And we had him on the show, what, in April?
In April,
yeah,
and he was probably about 35 pounds.
Yes.
because I think he was just 12 weeks old for the match show.
Right, right. But you can see.
And now he weighs, what, 97, 98?
Well, a week ago he was 98.
98, yeah. A week ago.
That's all right, guys. I don't care that I'm not in the program. You two just take over. That's perfectly all right with me. Why did you select this breed?
When I was in high school, my aunt had a Harlequin, and I just loved the dog. And I said, when I get out of school, I want a Great Dane, and I've had him ever since.
Wow. And you?
We got involved with wolfhounds through my father rescued a wolfhound.
Oh.
Back in, like, 1980.
Uh-huh.
And I think Kathy, my wife, fell in love with the breed more before we did, but
wow.
Before I did anyway.
Yeah.
And then we ended up, I don't think the dog lasted that long to rescue, and then we were devastated that we lost the dog and ended up pursuing, you know, some dogs to buy, and then we got into showing.
Wow.
And then we got into breeding.
Why are you?
How much do they eat?
The boys eat about between 6 to 8 cups a day. The girls about 4 to 6 cups.
Okay, same there?
Yeah, I'd say the same, yeah.
Okay,
yep.
So you know you're going to have a very large food bill. Bloat seems to be a big problem with the dogs with the real deep chests.
Yes.
You know, it just happens to, you know, so the Irish setters, and you wouldn't think that the Irish setters would be, but they do also have the deep chests. And they are also very sweet. I mean, he's a real love.
Yeah, he is. He's everybody always wants to take him home.
Yeah, it's a large head that he's hugging you with, but you know, he's a real sweetheart. Look at him. Just look at him. He's pretty cute. Well, I guess that's our program for this evening. And no, you can't have any of them, so you got to go get your own. So just call the Kennel Club if you're interested in this breed of dog. So for this month, good night.
All About Dogs on BCTV is supported by the Berks County Kennel Club and by the Berks County Dog Training Club.